Hey everybody, this is Steve Christensen, and in this video we're going to talk about retinal artery macroaneurysms, commonly referred to as RAMA. The clinical picture in this vignette is of an 80-year-old hypertensive Caucasian female who presented to our urgent clinic with new onset of floaters. Her vision was 20/250 in the left eye, and the anterior segment examination was normal. This is a fundus photo of her left eye, which shows a slightly hazy view due to the vitreous hemorrhage. Along the superior vascular arcade, you can see a discrete area of deep subretinal hemorrhage with a white spot in the very center, and perhaps you can also appreciate some preretinal hemorrhage just anterior to this white area. Based on her history and these exam findings, it was suspected that she had a retinal artery macroaneurysm. She returned 2.5 months later, and her vision had returned to 20/20, with resolution of the vitreous and subretinal hemorrhage, but persistence of this whitish macroaneurysm. Let's review some important features of retinal artery macroaneurysms. RAMAs are round dilations or aneurysms of retinal arterioles. They most commonly affect women in their sixth decade of life or later. They typically occur in just one eye and within the first three branches of the superotemporal retinal arteriole. The pathogenesis is not completely understood, but one theory is that systemic arteriosclerosis causes fibrosis within the wall of the vessel. The resulting decreased elasticity, coupled with systemic hypertension, leads to development of the macroaneurysm. If the macroaneurysm ruptures, hemorrhage can be seen at multiple levels, as can be seen in this photo of a different patient, in this case an 88-year-old hypertensive female, who also was believed to have a RAMA. You can see that the view is hazy once again due to dispersed vitreous hemorrhage. You can also see an area of likely preretinal hemorrhage centrally and surrounding deep subretinal hemorrhage. When this patient returned 3 weeks later, much of the vitreous and subretinal hemorrhage had resolved, but significant exudate remained, with subretinal fluid now involving the macula, which you can see on this OCT. A fluorescein angiogram was performed, but unfortunately did not clearly photograph the macroaneurysm. With that in mind, let me show you some wonderful FA photos of RAMA from the University of Iowa. Here you can see a fundus photo showing a large area of subretinal hemorrhage, with hemorrhage extending into the macula, and a small amount of preretinal hemorrhage as well. Notice the white spot along the superotemporal artery, which corresponds to the hyperfluorescent lesion on the angiogram. Here, in the mid-venous phase, there is increased hyperfluorescence, which persists a little bit later, seen here. Because the majority of macroaneurysms involute spontaneously, most patients can be safely observed without treatment, but hypertension and other vascular risk factors should be controlled as much as possible. Treatment options include laser photocoagulation, or especially in recent years, intravitreal anti-VEGF injections for macula involving subretinal fluid. In summary, retinal artery macroaneurysms typically occur in elderly women with systemic hypertension and present with a painless decrease in vision in one eye. Examination demonstrates hemorrhage at multiple levels, often with a focal white or yellow lesion at the center of the hemorrhage, most commonly within the first few branches of the superotemporal arteriole. RAMA can typically be observed, but anti-VEGF or laser could be considered. I hope you found this video to be helpful. Once again, this is Steve Christensen. Thanks for watching.